We are revealing a massive new push to make COVID vaccines more accessible, particularly in poor parts of the world. And it involves a familiar face. Academy Award winner Charlize Theron is teaming up with the Ford Foundation to fight vaccine misinformation and inequality. And COVID vaccine rate is less than 4% in Africa, where she was born. Theron told Jonathan Vigliotto how her organization, the Charlize Theron Africa Outreach Project, is helping.
As a fellow woman, I feel so inspired.
Charlize Theron's Africa Outreach Program has been fighting to prevent the spread of HIV/AIDS among South Africa's adolescent population since 2007.
Have members with your organization spoken with those on the ground in South Africa who are hesitant to get those vaccines because of misinformation that they've heard?
Yes, I mean, we've seen misinformation with HIV, so it's not new to us. It's in finding that right community-based health worker that will be able to sit down with somebody and speak to them in a language they understand, and they know her because they see her down the street.
Theron is now channeling her organization's grassroots network in the fight against COVID. Just 14% of South Africa's population of 60 million is fully vaccinated.
We have to remember that we're talking about families. When we see the devastation that COVID-19 has caused us personally here in America, it's so much worse in countries like South Africa.
You've been, you know, working tirelessly with, you know, helping on COVID testing, vaccination sites. What goes through your mind when you hear a lot of the anti-vaccine rhetoric?
It's a cowardice of conviction. I think that it is an unwillingness to engage in a culture of common sense that at this point it seems criminal to me, actually. I really feel that that if someone chooses not to be vaccinated, that they should choose to stay home, not go to work, not have a job.
I do not believe that people have a right to, point loaded guns in other people's faces, which is what they do when they go unvaxxed into the population.
I have been advocating for weeks that the United States military be fully mobilized.
You have any last words, Bartlett?
Yes, I do.
I have to say that I hope, I'd ask, that as much as I want people all to go to the theater, I really only want people who are vaccinated and safe to themselves and each other to go.